Penguin Random House Audio presents Yearbook by Seth Rogen. This is the author, Seth Rogen. Strap yourselves in. Bubby and Zaidy. I wanted to try stand-up comedy. I imagine if most 12-year-olds told their parents something like that, they'd be met with a healthy dose of skepticism. Fuck. If a 30-year-old told me they wanted to try stand-up comedy, I'd probably do my best to talk them out of it. Which makes it even more incredible that not only did my parents not scoff at the notion of it, they looked in the local newspaper and found a stand-up comedy workshop to enroll me in. I loved comedy growing up, I think, because my parents loved comedy. They would watch SCTV, Billy Crystal stand-up, Ghostbusters, Ferris Bueller's Day Off, Planes, Trains, and Automobiles, Uncle Buck, Home Alone, Coming to America, Big, Who Framed Roger Rabbit, Back to the Future, The Breakfast Club, When Harry Met Sally, What About Bob, and they would just laugh their fucking asses off, and I would laugh my fucking ass off, and if people were doing this for a living, then I was going to try to be one of those people. The workshop was simple enough. You'd spend a day learning the basic concept of stand-up joke writing, you'd write a few jokes, and then, that night, you'd go to the Lotus Club, a local lesbian bar with what, in retrospect, was a very vaginal flower painted on its awning, and perform your jokes for the lesbians. My mother dropped me off outside. I walked into the class, and not surprisingly, was the only kid. The first of about 1,000 rooms that I would walk into over the next decade where that was the case. I've been the youngest person in the room a lot of my life. There's something nice about having aged into my job, but still, I miss those days because when you're young, the bar for accomplishment is so low, no matter what you do, it's pretty impressive. If you're young enough, just walking is considered a huge deal. My friends are thrilled when their kids don't shit all over their floors. As an adult, I get little to no praise for doing the same. The teacher, a working stand-up comic named Mark Pooley, who looked exactly like Garth from Wayne's World, took the stage.
Nobody wants to hear about what you like. There's nothing less funny than hearing about the stuff you have fun doing. Fun isn't funny. Comedy is pain. It's struggle. So when thinking of what to write about, don't ask yourself, what's funny to me? Ask yourself, what bothers me? What frustrates me? What do I wish I could change? What can I just not fucking stand?
One answer popped into my head. At that point in my life, there was really only one answer. My grandparents. I didn't get along great with them back then. Their real names were Faye and Kelly, but I knew them as Bubby and Zaidy. Their last name was Bologus, which is by all means a hilarious last name. I remember being 13, hanging out at a friend's house, and telling him that my mother's maiden name was Bologus. His 9-year-old brother cackled loudly from the other room. Sounds like blow us. It sure does, I thought. It sure does. When I was younger, Bubby and Zaidy just didn't seem that into me. I got the impression they liked my older sister, Danya, more than me, mostly because their words and actions made it wildly clear that they did. They were just nicer to her, which didn't really bug me that much because I didn't love spending time with them. They were simultaneously tough and eccentric. My grandmother was born while her family was in a caravan fleeing Poland as World War I was breaking out. She got to pick her own birthday when she was a little girl because her parents didn't know her real one, which is some real Depression-era shit. How rough was Poland for Jews at that time? So rough that when they arrived in Winnipeg, a city in Manitoba that has swarms of mosquitoes throughout the summer and debilitating ice storms throughout the winter, they thought, this place is fucking great. Let's stay here. My grandfather was born in Winnipeg, one of three brothers, the others named Curly and Pinky. He played professional football in the CFL and lied about his age to go to war. When I was about 6, we were on a family vacation in Palm Springs and I cracked my toenail when I stubbed it in the pool. My grandfather said he would fix it and then he ripped off the entire nail. We had to go to the hospital. I didn't really start spending a lot of time alone with my grandparents until I was 10 and my sister was 13 getting ready for her bat mitzvah. She had to attend services every Friday and I did not want to do that, so my parents would drop me off at my grandparents' apartment to hang out for a few hours while they went to synagogue with my sister so she could pretend to pray. Every Friday night would play out the same. I would plant myself on Zaidy's Lazy Boy and turn on TGIF. ABC's Friday night programming, which consisted of Family Matters, Step by Step, and Hanging with Mr. Cooper, which are all shows that are, by any definition, fucking dope as fuck. My grandparents would make me a turkey sandwich on challah bread and pour me a glass of chocolate milk, and then sit with me as they tried their hardest to follow what the fuck was happening on these shows.
Who's that guy?
He's the dad.
Who's the dweeby one?
That's Steve Urkel.
And what's that? A robot?
Yes, Steve Urkel built it.
What's the robot doing now?
It's pretending to be Steve to trick the girl he likes into hooking up with him.
This show has not aged well.
Steve Snorkel?
Urkel.
And what's the show called?
Family Matters.
Family Bladders?
My grandfather worked in the engine room of a battleship in the Royal Navy during World War II and, as a result, was more or less deaf. He loved being in the Navy. He talked about it like most guys talked about their fraternity years. They would hang out, smoke cigars, talk shit, all while floating in thousands of tons of metal around the war-torn Horn of Africa. He arrived at Normandy on D-Day plus one, but his favorite story was about figuring out that if you broke your rationed rum bottle after drinking it, you could say you broke it before and get a double ration. Anyway, he was deaf.
Family crappers?
He's saying family campers.
No, I'm saying family matters.
Stop yelling.
Who's yelling?
You're yelling.
This would play out for about 2 hours straight, and as maddening as spending time with them was, I couldn't help but think they were entertaining. Because they grew up in the Depression, they would steal everything. Every time we went to McDonald's, they would empty the napkin dispenser and put them in a giant box that my grandfather kept in his van. If we were out at dinner and you heard my bubby say, "Oh, this is a nice plate," you knew the next time you ate at their place, you'd be eating off that plate because she straight jacked that shit. Knives, forks, you name it, they swiped it. Another thing I noticed was that my grandmother kind of had a wispy white afro that, when the light hit it, became completely see-through, leaving you with a very good idea of what my grandmother would look like if she was bald. And it was horrifying. I wrote 3 jokes about Bubby and Zaidy that followed the basic structure we were taught. Say the premise or the thing you don't like. Say why you don't like that thing by making a humorous observation. And then do an act out, an impression of the target of the joke, bringing it all together. My grandparents were hard to impersonate, so I thought I'd just go with a generic old Jewish person voice. It was a safe but ultimately good call. The night came and my turn to take the stage was fast approaching. I honestly don't remember being that nervous, probably because I was 12 fucking years old and wasn't even mature enough to be nervous. I've definitely gotten more in my head as I've gotten older, and I marvel at how I used to just barrel into these situations without much fear or anxiety. Kids can do that. It's like those very young Chinese acrobats you see, flinging their little bodies in the air, being thrown around, completely unaware of the stakes. If those kids knew what a torn ACL was, they wouldn't be letting those motherfuckers toss their little asses around like that. And if I had known the pain and shame that goes along with putting yourself out there creatively and being rejected, I probably wouldn't have been so excited. But I didn't. So I was. I took the stage. The lesbian's eyes locked on me.
So, people ask me what the hardest part about being Jewish is. The persecution? The repeated attempts at systematic annihilation? Nope. The hardest part about being Jewish is the grandparents.
They laughed. And thank fucking God they did, because if they didn't, I'd be one very frustrated video game store employee right now. I continued.
My grandparents argue all the time, but they're both deaf, so they don't even know what the other one is arguing about.
Time for the big quasi-anti-Semitic act out.
Hey, Kelly, pass me a pillow.
What? I'm an armadillo? Why would you call me this animal? What? I'm not wearing flannel.
Small laugh, but enough to keep going, which could also be the title of this book. I went on.
My grandmother has a thin white afro, and when the light hits her hair a certain way, you can see right through it and she looks bald. It's weird to see what your bubby would look like completely bald. She looks like Gandhi in a pink floral tracksuit.
I finished it off with a joke about the stolen napkins that got a so-so laugh, and then I fucked off. The lesbians loved me. A guy who worked at another comedy room gave me his card and asked if I would perform there next week. All those times I was dreading hanging out with my bubby and Zaidy suddenly became something else. Something new. They were fodder. They were material. I also began to suspect that maybe, just maybe, they knew they were being funny. They would come and watch me perform from time to time, and not only did they not mind when I made fun of them, they got pissed off when I didn't.
Where were our jokes? We're not funny anymore.
Don't worry, you're still plenty funny.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.